Some baseball fans are beginning to hear the crack of the bat, the pop of the mitt, and see new and old faces donning their team's unis as players across the major leagues report to their various spring training locations. With that in mind, here are a few storylines to be aware of entering the first full week of the new baseball year. Here we go. Due to the large number of free agents still out on the market, the Major League Baseball Players Association will hold a free agent spring training for the second time in the sport's history, the first and only other time coming in 1995, and that was after a labor dispute ended the remainder of the 94 season. One big name who will not be at the free agent camp is Yu Darvish. He recently signed with the Chicago Cubs. Last year, he went 10-12 with a 3.86 ERA for the Rangers and Dodgers. His season ended, however, with a disastrous World Series, having given up 8 earned runs in 3 1/3 innings across 2 starts, and there were reports that he was tipping his pitches. But with the Cubs, having reached the NLCS last year, he may get his shot at redemption in the Fall Classic. Another highly anticipated signing was 25-year-old Shohei Ohtani to the Los Angeles Angels, who, like Darvish, played for Japan's Nippon Ham Fighters, where he was a two-way star. Take a listen to these numbers, hitting .286 with 48 homers and 166 RBIs in just over 400 plate appearances, and going 42-15 with a sub-3 ERA as a starter. To take advantage of the possibilities Ohtani offers, the Angels will reportedly use a 6-man rotation to give Ohtani the opportunity to DH on a couple of games in between starts. I'm incredibly interested to see how this plays out. Before signing, Ohtani made clear that he wanted such a challenge, which I think will prove incredibly difficult to successfully accomplish. Pitching against big leaguers is daunting, and hitting a baseball is the hardest thing to do in sports. Not to mention, if the plan plays out, he will be disrupting other big leaguers' routines. We'll see how the experiment goes when the real games begin at the end of March. I cannot wait. With your spring training report, I'm Matt Uris for CBS Local Sports.